The world of Instagram Reels can feel really intimidating, especially if you're not confident jumping in front of a camera like this. And that's exactly why we're going to be creating these three types of Instagram Reels that are really easy to make within Canva, even for a complete beginner. And then we're going to be matching these really short video clips with trending sounds within the Instagram app, which is massively going to increase your chances of going viral with these. And yes, of course, you can use these same skills for your TikTok videos and your YouTube shorts. So if you're ready, let's get creating. So jumping into Canva, just start by searching for the word tweet, and then you can just pick a vertical template or narrow this down by your story, which is going to just give you any template that's in that format already. If you're on the pro account, you can select any one of these. If you're on the free account, just look out for ones that don't have the pro crown. There's lots and lots of beautiful templates that are free for you to use, no matter which Canva subscription you're in at the moment. Then I'm just going to zoom in and customize the actual tweet first. So I would delete some of these elements. I find them to be a bit clunky, and my blue tick, I don't really have one of those, so I would definitely remove that. I would put in my username and my name, and then I would just put in a quote that would be kind of my personal tweet. So obviously not using somebody else's tweet for this purpose. And I don't particularly like this blue circle that's around this image, so I would just make sure I am stretching the image all the way to the edges, and I'm just gonna remove that blue circle. So then I would just bring in my actual profile photo. So I've got my images here, but you can also just chuck them into your uploads folder as well if you don't have folders organized like this. And then we want to bring in our video into the background. So I would search for something like gradient, because these are really beautiful videos that aren't too distracting if you've got something in front of them. I really particularly like these kind of videos here because they actually loop in on themselves. So I'm gonna pull one in and show you what I mean. Basically, the way that they start is the way that they finish, because they have kind of like a mini transition. So you'll notice that this is the end of the video and this is the beginning of the video, and it looks the same because there is a kind of a transition around here. So for a looping reel, that can be really powerful, but of course this is 13 seconds, so we may not necessarily be using all 13 seconds of this type of video. I would also probably just put it, that's just me being pedantic, but I would probably put it on its vertical side and put that to the back, just so that it looks a little bit, it's got a little bit more real estate that way. And then I would bring my actual tweet down just to the center of my graphic here, and I'm gonna change this to be black so it actually looks like a tweet. Now for our second round, we're gonna be tapping into the hilarious power of memes, so I hope you're excited. So we're gonna create a new page, we're gonna head on over to templates, and now we're gonna be looking for a meme template. So it really doesn't matter which one you're using, because you are going to customize this to whatever text you're putting in there. And I would just update all of the text here to match whatever was up here. It doesn't necessarily need to be the exact font that I'm using here. As long as you're being consistent, that's totally fine. And then I would just update this the same way as I did in my previous design. So I'm gonna bring in my profile photo. I'm gonna put in my name, and then I'm gonna put in my handle here. Now, in terms of actually creating memes, look, this can be a bit of a minefield because, you know, it's not an easy thing to kind of keep coming up with hilarious things to say all the time. But as long as it's relevant to your audience and to your industry, so that if this type of reel does go viral, you haven't created something that's totally out of left field for you. For me, you know, I'm going to be saying, hey, me, I'm ready for anything life can throw at me. Me 10 seconds later after seeing an email from a client marked urgent, right? And then I'm going to bring in a hilarious GIF here that's going to go along with this meme, because this cat doesn't really make nearly as much sense for me. So this is something that's really relevant to me because I teach people how to freelance. So that makes sense. And I do like using GIFs here instead of just images, even though we're gonna be using a video in the background. If you're not seeing Giphy as an extension there, just head on over to more and you can pull from it here. But I really like using GIFs there because I think it just adds a little something extra. Now, for our video to the back, I like making it really related to the GIF whenever possible. And I would also be using an underwater clip that's, you know, color-wise is quite similar, not any of these really light blue ones. And our third reel is probably the simplest one to make, but can have a really big impact, which is gonna be just using a really cool and powerful quote with an awesome video in the background. So keeping things nice and simple for our third template here, we're just gonna bring in a little bit of text. I'm gonna bring in a quote, whether it's something you've said or, you know, just something you're bringing in from someone else. And then in terms of the fonts you use for something like this, I don't really have an issue with people using fonts that aren't necessarily their branded fonts, as long as they still sort of, this would make sense to somebody that coming across their feed and they would recognize it as you. And for this type of reel, you want to be using quite a soothing background video. If you can't find what you're looking for here, so, you know, there's beautiful kind of videos of clouds that are really serene, and you can use any of the gradient ones as well. If you can't find what you're looking for, that's free for you to use. For those of you who don't have pro accounts, just head on over to Pexels and you can usually just find really beautiful stuff that's free for you to use, that you can then download and just drag into your Canva template, and it'll appear in your uploads folder, and then you can bring it in that way. That's exactly what I've done. I've already just put it in a folder for myself because I do use these quite a lot. But these are just videos from Pexels that I've brought in, and I really, really like them because, you know, they're quite bright, colorful, and they especially go with a quote like this one here. So in terms of the actual colors you want to be using, I would probably go for something that's along the same kind of color lines as this video in the background. But if you find that it's a little bit distracting, so for example, the video maybe in this section, the quote would be a little bit hard to read, you can just go on over to FX and give it a bit of a background. So the way to kind of trick that so it still looks cool at the beginning is to just head over to the beginning of the video, go on over to FX, and then for your background color, just go to document colors, color picker, and select the background of this so that when it actually comes through, that's when the background will appear like that. And this is really cool. I think it's got quite an impact. One thing you want to make sure is that you're not trimming your video too much, because you don't really know what sound you're going to be using yet, and the sound might be a little bit long. So if you trim this to like 5 seconds, then you don't have the option to go longer. So I like keeping these at about 15 seconds. I also like just sort of starting the video right when the impact is about to come in, because you have to sort of account for the fact that people have a very short attention span on platforms like Instagram. So you don't want to be giving them time to tune out. But around that 13 second mark is a pretty good place to start with this. So that's the first thing to keep in mind. The second thing is obviously you don't want to have anything too close to the edges here and too close to the bottom, because that's where you're going to have other on-screen elements inside of Instagram. But you can always check that as you're uploading it to Instagram and make sure everything looks good. And just before you go in and download that, I would animate my beautiful text either as a typewriter or maybe burst, so that the text itself is also moving while this is moving as well. So then if we go in and just play that at the very end, we can see how that's going to look when it first appears. I think that's quite cool. So it's really, really dynamic. It makes people want to stick around and read the rest of the quote. Then I'm going to go ahead and download each of these files individually. Otherwise, it's going to give you one big MP4 file, which can be hard to work with. And then I'm going to airdrop that to my phone, or you can just open up the Canva app on your phone and just download it straight from there onto your phone so you can open it up in Instagram. So jumping on over to Instagram, you might have to go through a couple of reels until you find one that has the little trending arrow in the bottom left-hand corner. But these can be a really great way to get some music that will really work with these kind of reels. Obviously, you want to get some music that's almost like background music that might work better. So this might be a good option because it is kind of more of a background song. We can save the audio for later, and we can also just use it straight away. And then we can come in here and bring in one of our beautiful videos. I would only want to be using a couple of seconds, like 5 seconds maximum, or around 5 seconds. And I would want to make sure I'm stopping the video where the octopus has disappeared, because that's going to make it really easy to loop. And then in terms of the actual audio I'm using, I will probably want to be selecting a different part of the audio clip where the beat starts already kind of pumping, which will again make the actual audio easier to loop, because it'll not be a huge pattern interrupt. Like if you're using the very start of the song where the beat is really slow, then it makes it a bit more awkward to loop that. So I want to make sure I'm going to where the beat starts. I think that's good. Let's have a look. That's pretty good. So you'll notice that when it loops, it doesn't have that huge pattern interrupt on the audio or in the video. It's really, really nice and loopy, for the lack of a better word. So then you could essentially go over to preview and then next. And so for me with the cover, I would at least select a shot where the octopus is visible because it's a little bit more interesting than just the beginning. Then you can obviously write your caption, your tags, and share that. Or you can save it as a draft so that you can continue creating your other reels and then post them at a time that's more convenient. And that's it for this tutorial. But if you'd like to learn more about how to use Canva for social media in similar ways, make sure to check out my best-selling Skillshare course in the description of the video. Thank you guys so much for being here, and I will see you in the next one.